And we begin tonight with Supreme Court Justice Brett Kavanaugh facing a new allegation of inappropriate sexual behavior as a college student, as several defenders tonight race to his side. The allegation, first reported by the New York Times and set to appear in a new book about the embattled justice, describes Kavanaugh exposing himself at a party while he was a student at Yale. The Times reporting the allegation came from a male classmate this time who says he alerted senators and the FBI, but the claim was never investigated. Kavanaugh survived a heated confirmation fight with multiple accusations of sexual misconduct that the FBI said they could not corroborate. Tonight, some Democratic 2020 hopefuls are calling for his impeachment, but Kavanaugh supporters are also raising questions about what they say are major flaws in the New York Times report. ABC's Kira Phillips is at the Supreme Court.
Tonight, new questions about a new report, another sexual assault allegation against Justice Brett Kavanaugh, this one reportedly never pursued by the FBI. The New York Times publishing the previously unreported account of Max Steyer, one of Kavanaugh's former Yale classmates, writing, Steyer told senators and the FBI he saw Kavanaugh expose himself at a party his freshman year and saw Kavanaugh's friends pushing him into a female student's hand. Steyer telling ABC News he's not speaking publicly. But Kavanaugh's defenders say the Times essay, adapted from a forthcoming book about the justice, does not tell the full story, pointing out the book says the female student didn't wish to speak publicly, and her friend said she doesn't remember the incident. Today, President Trump also coming to Kavanaugh's defense, tweeting, he is an innocent man who has been treated horribly. Such lies about him. Brett Kavanaugh should start suing people for libel, or the Justice Department should come to his rescue. After President Trump nominated Kavanaugh to the court, another former Yale classmate, Deborah Ramirez, alleged Kavanaugh exposed himself to her at a different party when they were both drunk. She says she shoved him away, accidentally touching him.
Are Ms. Ramirez's allegations about you true?
Those are not. None of the witnesses in the room support that. If that had happened, that would have been the talk of campus in our freshman dorm.
Ramirez and Dr. Christine Blasey Ford, two of the women who stepped forward during Kavanaugh's heated confirmation proceedings, questioning his fitness to serve on the nation's highest court. At the time, the FBI launched an investigation and found no corroboration of the allegations. The justice denied all claims of sexual assault. But this new report prompting Democratic candidates for president to call for Kavanaugh's impeachment. Senator Kamala Harris, who serves on the Senate Judiciary Committee, tweeting, he was put on the court through a sham process, and his place on the court is an insult to the pursuit of truth and justice. Republicans saying Democrats need to move on.
There's nobody they don't want to impeach. And at some point, they just have to let the anger go.
All right, Kira Phillips joins us now from outside the Supreme Court. And Kira, any indication the House Judiciary Committee would open an investigation? And what's the FBI saying tonight?
Well, it's possible. Sources say it's not likely, though. And Democrats in Congress are saying that their options are limited, and removing Kavanaugh from the bench would require the Republican-controlled Senate to go along. Now, tonight, the FBI is telling me they're not going to comment on this story, Tom. And so far, neither is Justice Kavanaugh.
Kira Phillips. Thank you, Kira.
Hi, everyone. George Stephanopoulos here. Thanks for checking out the ABC News YouTube channel. If you'd like to get more videos, show highlights, and watch live event coverage, click on the right over here to subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to download the ABC News app for breaking news alerts. Thanks for watching.